New updates and evidence have been revealed in the YNW Melly case, which will have him serving the rest of his life in prison, which we will show you in today's video, so make sure you watch until the end. You will not want to miss what we have to show you. Also, if you are a fan of YNW Melly, leave a like on this video, and if you would like to enter this month's giveaway of a new pair of AirPods, all you have to do is leave a like on this video, subscribe to the channel, and comment innocent or guilty, and you will be entered. Now, YNW Melly has been one of the most talked about rappers this year, not only for all of his fans he's gained from his music, but also because of the criminal charges he's facing and what's happening in court. YNW Melly has been awaiting a verdict in his case for quite a while now. This has been a crazy case with so many allegations and ups and downs that the verdict is going to cause a lot of problems either way it goes. Many people, including YNW Melly, believe that he was set up and framed, while other people believe it's obvious that he was the ones who committed the crimes. Investigators believe that the ballistic tests prove that this was staged by YNW Melly and Courtland Henry. For those who are new to this case, YNW Melly is currently sitting in jail awaiting his verdict after being charged with 2 counts of first-degree murder for the death of his 2 childhood friends, YNW Juvie and YNW Sack Chaser. Not only is Melly facing life in prison from these charges, but he also faces a death penalty if he is found guilty. Also, he is a suspect of a 2017 murder of an officer, but that's a topic for a different time since he has to get past these 2 murder charges first before that even becomes a problem. So far, there hasn't been any clear evidence that should determine his fate, but with the newest updates prosecutors have released, crime scene photos to the public from this case. These photos show the bullet holes as well as police techniques to try and determine the bullet trajectory. The police theory is that YNW Melly shot them both inside the car and then got out of the car and shot up the car to make it look like a drive-by shooting. But what's interesting about that is one of the headshot theories mapped out by police has the bullet coming from behind the car and through both seats. YNW Melly was sitting on the left side, so he would have had to reach his arm around the back seat and shoot a headshot through 2 seats. Does not seem very likely at all. Also worthy of note is there were never any proven facts or real scientific evidence to the truth that these type of mapping out by police work with bullet trajectory. There's no truth to that. A lot of evidence seems like it would help YNW Melly in almost proving he was innocent because there are a lot of holes in this case and it does seem sketchy about a lot of the things the police are trying to prove and what they are saying. But there also is a lot of bad evidence against YNW Melly. And in his situation, it's not good at all. Investigators found shell casings from the incident on a different road than the road the drive-by shooting was said to have happened. This is a conflict of statement on YNW Melly's part, which is never a good thing in investigations like this, especially when he tells that he is truly innocent. Having holes in your story and lies that do not add up never looks good and it does not prove innocence at all. There have been a lot of conspiracy theories about this case, about the police setting him up. This comes from the shell casing that was found in the car inside of a plastic bag, because why would Melly put a casing in a bag and leave it in the car? Makes absolutely no sense and has people turning their heads to police corruption, especially since there have been recent news and events about police officers caught planting evidence on innocent people. And having that bullet casing in a plastic bag in the car, most people would say that that looks very suspicious and does not seem very plausible in any type of sense for YNW Melly to do. Again, this is speculation and opinion if that is what really happened in this case, but hopefully the truth will come out soon, especially since there seems to be no motive at all for YNW Melly to shoot his 2 best friends. There has not been a motive proven in court. If the police are trying to set him up, this does not look good for YNW Melly. There could be a big chance he may be found guilty regardless of the amount of evidence proving his innocence, especially if the police are actually against him in trying to convict him. We will have to wait and see what happens. I do think that it will be very hard for YNW Melly to be proven innocent, especially when some of his stories don't add up. And also there have been stories that don't add up that Courtland Henry has also said to the police. So it does not look good for him. It's going to be very hard for him to beat this case. In my opinion, there is a big possibility he will be spending the rest of his life in prison. Hopefully not going anywhere near the death penalty case, but we still have to wait and see. With that being said, I am going to end the video here. I do want to know what you think about this in the comments. Do you think he's truly innocent or do you think he is guilty? Also, do you think the police are setting him up? Because if that is true and it did come to the light with the amount of media behind this case, that would be crazy and would cause a lot of problems. But we will have to wait and see for the verdict of what really happens. It should be coming up very soon. If you are a YNW Melly fan, leave a like on this video. Also, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe and I will see you in the next one.